Hey guys, welcome to the stream space, or welcome back if you've been here before. Here is the skinny. We are doing kind of our first stream from our new house. We don't have everything quite set up yet, but welcome nonetheless. It does look like a bomb went off behind me. I promise it was a very low yield, so all my possessions seem to still be intact. But anyways, we're here to play Palworld. Now, this has been kind of like a sweep the nation type of game. It's getting a lot of clout, and it's deserved it from what I've played of it so far. So while this is a first impressions for you guys with me, it's not my first time playing it. I played a bit with my fiance. Oh, I just lost. That was a weird noise. My headset made a noise just now. Strange. Okay, anyways, I might have to put him on charge while we play. Where is... Moving sucks, because you never know where your charger's... It's like the first thing you lose track of is your chargers. We're going to fix this real quick so that it can charge while we play. Anyways, now, so, what is Palworld, before we get too far into this? Palworld is a Pokemon clone, for lack of a better word, except it mixes in elements from games like Ark Survival, you got some Minecraft, maybe a little bit of, obviously, Pokemon. There's some gunplay in it, kind of gives you some almost Fortnite-y type vibes. So I guess that's kind of where the mix is, but it's the main thing is like you can catch creatures and they're called pals and you can kind of make them your friend and do stuff, and it's fun. It's a lot of fun, and there's some slavery and some animal labor involved. I don't know if that's technically a bad thing, but it doesn't matter. So let's jump right in. So we got the good old whatever this is. We're gonna start a game. I'm gonna make one just to play with you guys. Palworld is for the streams, boys and girls. We're gonna do a normal difficulty game. I don't want multiplayer. This is gonna just be me and you guys. And we'll say yes. Let's just jump right in. Let's go. Excuse the wire draped across me, because I have to... Okay, so where we start off with is a character creator. Giant torso! But not giant torso. Really small torso! Mid-level torso.
Giant arms!
Tiny arms. I'ma fuck you up! You got any drugs? Anyways. Skip leg day. Did not skip leg day. Change the eye color? You can. Cool. So, for anybody who's, like, kind of curious, this is a game that's, like, in a state of pre-alpha. Or, sorry, it's, like, early preview. That's so much better. Yeah, so you kind of start in the wild. There's, like, some weird ruins around you, but... let's jump straight into it. So, the first thing you kind of want to do, from what I've played, is get your initial crafting bench started up. Oh, look, there's a pal right now. This is called a chicopee. They're ridiculous, and I love them. I need to go punch a tree so I can get some wood. There's some wood down there. I don't gotta punch a tree to get wood. Oh, there's this big motherfucker here. He seems fine with me. Until I beat the shit out of him with a stick. Then he won't be fine with me. Get the stick, stupid! I should probably make it so I can see my chat, hey? Oh, for God's sake. Anyways, let's get back to business here. You do have to contend with daylight and nighttime. Like, it's an actual thing. Okay, I leveled up because I got wood. Unlock this immediately. This is fast travel. So if we dive... What the fuck? He is, he's right there. That is a very large mammoth-type creature. Okay. One of those ancient devices. I don't know what that means. Well, you guys gonna meet up in the middle, have an epic battle? I don't know. I want one of these things. Mamarest. You look like Breelium's much cuter cousin. Hey, look, a lamb ball. And a chickpea. Okay, so what can we... We got build. We got a primitive workbench. Let's do this. So, you got a... build it, but then you gotta you set the production in motion and then you have to build it. So from what I've played, I would then at this point go get a creature. Like if you get Kativa or Lamball, they can actually work in these spaces. And I see that we got a bot. I'm pretty sure it's a bot. There's a bot in here. Fun fact, if you use this, if you do create the torch, it is a little handy because if you are out in the wild when it gets dark and it gets cold, you can actually equip it to generate some warmth and at least get yourself back to safety. And your scroll wheel is how you can change this. There's a lamb ball and chickpea. Lots of wood. It's not really wood that I need right now. I am not a fan of the feeling of this charging cable sitting on my neck. It is actually irritating the fuck out of me. I will not have speakers until tomorrow, though, alas. So... And here's a rock. We need 5 stones to do this one. Can I beat this rock up and get stone out of it or not? Okay, you can, but you don't get it as efficiently as you would with, say... Okay, so we can now build a pickaxe, and that'll let us get stuff a little more efficiently, which... I don't know if you saw, but I looked over a cliff and there were some blue rocks down. That is called palladium. And that's what you use to actually... Are you kidding me? I didn't get enough stone. I punched all of that rock for nothing. It's just a little flock of chickpea and lamb ball. Give me one more piece of rock, damn it. Okay, good enough. But yeah, it's got the kind of the Ark-esque leveling system, which I really like. But this will give me my ability to actually catch pals. So what we need, and also you'll be more efficient at things like mining. So if I go mine this rock now. After every 3 to 5 hits with my fist, I would get rock, but now I'm going to get it pretty much every time. Ding, 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 see? So chipping away at it a lot faster. You even get some palladium fragments from these that you can use to... Okay, so let's go make my axe, because that's how you can retrieve wood. We'll see if we can also get a pal sphere made. Think we can catch 2 buddies with this. Now, the first thing we're gonna do them. That's another thing. Maybe they'll fix it later, but if you make something at the bench, collect it, because it doesn't do it automatically. Come here, you little fucker. You're mine now. We have a friend. Sweet. Okay. I got him! I thought I totally missed. I did not miss. I caught the pal. Now we got the chickpea. Now, chickpeas are... they're okay. Again, they're very honest about the leveling. Dinosaur. Cool. Now we can do a little bit of... that mana rest, I think that was what I was hearing. We're gonna go retrieve some stone and palladium. Let's go focus on palladium. You get a little bit from just kind of coming at hacking at these mine ores, these like ore veins. But there's some down here just like dedicated. You see, we got chickpea and lamball now as like actual summonables. And I guess like the interface kind of will remind you of Arceus a little bit. Oh, there's a Kativa. Kativa's really good if you need something to help you work. And his Fury Swipe type attack is actually really nasty. Give me that. Oh, shit. No, no, get back in the ball. I'm gonna hurt you. Come here. I wish I could throw something at you. Okay, these guys are moving slow. Let's go after these guys. Ah. Fuck! I got rock blocked. Great. Ah! See, that's the attack. That's the one. Excuse me, sir. Like, you don't have to be an absolute menace to everybody. Hey! Ah! Okay, now, I'm gonna try and find those damn Kativas again. Or at least a Kativa, because they are particularly handy for general existence. There's some over there. Again, we have forgotten to actually obtain the thing that we were creating. Spain. I'm gonna go God of War on your ass. Here. Get the damn ball. I gotta remember not to do that. Let's go. We gotta deal with our food. How do we use it? I didn't kill all these. I don't know what you're talking about. I think we need some other materials. young man will be a worker. A finished pow sphere. It's nice to see that sometimes. And then we can work together and build it even faster. I didn't mean to neglect my leveling like this, but it lets me be a little more picky, I suppose. Now, I needed to get two cloth for each of the two recipes I'm about to do. So I want to do this for the outfit, because then you can actually, like, I think you actually, it increases, like, your resistance to cold. Yeah, so, like, it immediately... Yeah, cool. So we have an extra food on us. Thank you. these together. We'll be here for a minute. Mine now. Our way down this ravine here and start maybe running into some little more unique pals here. Take depression if you not want to fuck with that thing. Yeah. No, I don't think I will. Seriously? Fuck me. That sucks. I should have left that treasure chest there with some extras in here for me. I might tone that whole component down of, oh, you gotta do this and you gotta, like, hold on to all your stuff. Like, you have to, you lose your stuff if you get knocked. Like, I think if I'm playing solo, I might actually tone that part down ever so slightly. Get down to my stuff really fast as I can, though, because the clothing in there is what's gonna kind of keep me alive. Stupid fucking elk ass bitch. Got a Kremis and a Gumos, they could have helped. It's a flack. There's a little flack over there. No sign of the bastard that tried to kill me. That's a ribcage. That's absolutely a ribcage. Come on. Yeah. Ah, of course there's more than one. Retreat! That's so dumb. Are you fucking kidding me? Ugh. How do you fast heal? What the fuck? That is some fucking brutal shit right there. It's like... Was I stupid and didn't activate the fucking thing again? Yeah, I was. I was fucking stupid. That was fucking dumb. My own goddamn fault, too. This game is fucking frustrating. Like, I feel like that's kind of like a... I didn't really want to do that level of survival. Like, it's a little fucking unfair. And it's so dumb, like, you attack one and they all come after you. Like, I get that it's kind of like herd mentality because of the type of creature it was, but it seems like all of them do that. So we're gonna go down and activate that thing before we do anything else. I'm gonna try and catch a flak on the way over there, though. Ah, oh, there's a Foxspark. Foxsparks. Come on, help me out here, man. Wait, if I already activated this, why couldn't I select this? Because it's a fast travel spot and not a respawn, because I'm an idiot. Alright, let's try this again. Yeah, we're basically building base in your backyard, buddies, because best believe I'm coming for you. I've been pissed off how many times you fucking killed me, you prick. is so funny how he just like runs it. No, fucking... Ugh! That is really fucking annoying. I really wanted one of those, and I wasted so many things to try and get one. And I think it really got me fucked up when I was, like, over-encumbered. And this part is, like, just all part of mastering the management of the game, because that's, like, just fucking crawling on my ass over here. Like, fuck. What am I fucking so weighed down by? Oh, yeah, that makes sense. Okay, so let's go make some more fucking arrows. I mean, like, don't get me wrong, I like the management system of the game. That was more my screwing up. I wasn't managing myself properly. What the hell is that? I'm confused. What is that? Okay. He's got a thing. Whatever. He found a thingy. Whatever. Wonderful. Okay, can we make some more pal spheres? Yes, we can. So bring him back. Man, that makes me so mad. I really wanted that guy. The ghostly or the ethereal. Oh. I totally thought I had to wait. Huh? some points for not making me have to, like... I don't know, like, add more stuff. Like, I don't have to, like... It doesn't have to be in my inventory to use things, like, to build things. I actually found this out playing out with my fiancé. Like, you have to actually put... Like, if as long as you're in the base with the item, that's good enough. I mean, I like how you can join in and help them build stuff. And it makes sense, because, I mean, you had to build it yourself in the first place. coin here. We'll get some Harvest Moon vibes too. Thanks for the overkill, Daydream. Jesus fuck. Fucking anarchist. Fuck, I really need to reverse those controls, because that is... I cannot tell you how many times I have thrown an accidental pal sphere. I have wasted so many of them. Cut. really wanted that pangolin, but yeah, I guess I'm not allowed to have that, I suppose. Fuck. What? The fucking actual. Fucking annoying. This is some bullshit. Fuck's sakes. That is stupid. Like, I was running up that hill. And that's really fucking irritating. Yeah, respawn here. What the fuck do you... What do you think? Where do you think I want to respawn? I don't fucking recollect my stuff because this game was kind of a dick about how it handled, like, stamina regeneration. Like... You put it up there? Fuck you. Another egg over there. This is so stupid! That is fucking bullshit! Yeah, so let's just die again. Fuck it, dumb. Oh my god, there are definitely some kinks to work out in this fucking game. The hit detection on that edge, I totally should have been on it. Dropped all weapons and items. No shit, Sherlock. Fuck, that was stupid. Not asking for a lot here, man. Fuck. Well, let's go fucking retrieve my stuff again. Even further up the hill than last time. This is so stupid. All this over some fucking life monk fucking energy. This is dumb. And it's gonna, like, damage my stuff too, so. Let's fucking do this again. Oh, I'll take some fall damage for this. Oh, no, I guess not. Why are you up? Excuse me? Don't give me attitude. Is almost like it's over 2 hours after you were sent to bed, Drake. Doesn't even sound like you've been sleeping, so move it. I'm not going to be playing it too much longer, but I'm trying to... we survived our first attack. Alright, guys, so I think that's going to be the end of the stream. I mean, right. Be hanging around doing a few things, but I might play on my Steam Deck or something, but I am done streaming for the night. Thanks for checking it out, for those who did pop in. Some of the regulars didn't come by, it's kind of sad. But anyways, thanks for checking out Stream Space. I'm Pydara. You would know this, you already, if you haven't subscribed, I mean, I hope you do. But anyways, this is the, we'll keep this one live for the stream. We'll come back to this one just so you guys can see. We'll strictly play this one with you guys. What I think is, this is almost, in a lot of ways, the perfect mishmash between a few different game types. So we got some arc with that leveling system and the craft and the way the crafting kind of works. You know, we got some Minecraft almost to an extent with the, you know, managing hunger and stuff like that. I mean, you kind of, like, honestly, it really, I think at the closest comparison, so it's not Minecraft with Pokemon, it's definitely Ark with Pokemon. So it's basically everything Ark except for obviously adding the creatures in and then letting them kind of work the farm and stuff like that. So there's some farm management kind of elements. So almost like Harvest Moon Pokemon, Ark had a baby. This is what it is, and you know, there might be some child support involved because we're not sure whose kid that is. There's going to be a DNA test involved. I would have to say this is an interesting first impressions video because, like, I heard so much about this. I played a little bit privately, and I really liked what I played. It was fun, but it's definitely in a lot of ways unpolished, as you saw, like me just trying to go from one place to another, that wasn't fun. I mean, I tried to use the parachute, aka glider, and it was, the way that your stamina seems to not increase very quickly, or like, you have to, you know, really, really monitor like when you make that leap and how far you are away from the next, the place you're trying to get to, because the hit detection is not fantastic on the corners of like platforms and stuff. So if you are not careful, you're gonna get killed by fall damage, or if there is any, I don't know if there's fall damage, but you'll get killed by like falling in water and having no way to replenish your stamina, because as soon as you hit that water, it keeps going down. So I mean, one thing maybe they could take from Minecraft is perhaps take the take the stamina for water, give it its own type of stamina. So like the Minecraft has the swimming one where you can go underwater and stuff. Otherwise you can stay in the water forever, but maybe give swimming its own specific stamina bar. It might not be a bad idea. But what I can say is, like, as far as the first impression goes, like, so we got some pretty decent graphics, some interesting mechanics that you haven't really seen in the same environment with each other. Like, they don't typically show up together. So that's kind of what I'm thinking, is like that's kind of the cool part, is that these weird mechanics are all in the same place, and it's actually a lot of fun to see them in the same place. And like, we have done some, you know, arrow firing, but we haven't seen the guns yet, so I'm excited to see what those can be. But as far as the first impression goes, I mean, I think it made a really good first impression. I think that we got easily a 7 out of 10, and that is in an early access game. Its cross-platform is active, but I find that it's a teeny bit... they're not keeping up with each other in terms of the updates, so like, I tried to play with my fiancé off the console version. I ended up having to play off my laptop. It seems to be also well optimized for the PC, so like it's not super choppy. It plays on lower end systems almost the same way that it played on this super high end system. So I don't got anything to really complain about except for some of those unpolished edges. As I'm making this assessment, I am remembering that the game itself is in early access. It is not finished. So, and that's okay. It's okay that it's not finished. They're not charging a finished price for it anyways, but I can see this going the same route that Ark went, and that's not a bad thing. Like, except for, you know, maybe it'll be maybe more successful because it's like, oh, we get Pokemon that we can fight with. We also can turn them into weapons. Like, you can literally turn Foxsparks into a flamethrower, and I bet that Pendulet actually turns into an ice beam of some kind, because, I mean, he's the ice equivalent, and you can get parts from him, so you can create. So, from what I've seen, definitely a positive. We'll say a 7 out of 10. So here's what we like. We like the graphics. We like the unique mix between the different genres. Excuse me. I like the art. I really like the way the characters look. I like the way your character looks. The character customization was pretty decent. Now here's what we don't like. And again, through the filter of this is not a finished game. Really enjoying I really didn't like that little hit detection thing where it didn't land on the ledge. It landed on just the corner of it and then fell into the water. And then there's obviously like some of the survival mechanics might need some tweaking, like just how you burn through stamina maybe could be balanced out a little bit better. Aside from that, so you know what, let's just say I'll say 8 out of 10. 8 out of 10 out of the gates with some minor tweaks easily could pop up to a 9. The world, I guess, okay, you know what? No, I'll keep it at 7, and this is where the third point removal comes from. The world is a little empty. Yeah, you can tell that this is an ancient world. There's ruins and stuff like that. There's some people who are already on the island. But we don't know what's going on. We don't know why we're there, or if there's some grand overarching story. So, I mean, I'm hoping that'll get fleshed out a little bit better as time goes by. So, again, through the filter of it's not a full launch title, right? So, thanks for checking out the stream space. I'm Pydera. You can find me over on YouTube, PyderaSpace74, where, or over on Twitch, Pydera_74. Right now, we do stream to both, and the intention is to kind of keep it that way for the next little bit. Of course, if we receive YouTube, like, if we start working with YouTube, or if Twitch makes us an affiliate, then we're obviously going to have to pick and choose at that point. But until that time, we are currently actively on both and proud to be so. So there's a couple different ways to support the channel. You can like, follow, subscribe. Like, that is kind of like the go-to. We always suggest that one. That's just a button click. Nice and easy. The next ones, Let's dive into them. So the second way you can support us is through our partnership with Dubby. You can actually use creator code Pydera74 on their website when you're placing an order, and we get about 10% of that, so that's pretty awesome. In addition to that, obviously you get a pretty cool energy drink. Now, we don't have any at the moment, or else I'd be showing you all about it, but Dubby is one of my favorite. They're kind of like the equivalent of the G Fuel and a couple other ones. They're really good. They taste great. They don't leave you with any weird feelings or the jitters or anything like that. It's nice and smooth. And they all, so far, like all the ones I've tasted have been just straight up fantastic. They're so good. And they got some tumblers and they got other merch. Definitely worth checking out if you use that code. We get a little piece, so it all works out. The last one, of course, is the most direct one. You'll find a tip link in it for Streamlabs in our profile description on YouTube. And you can directly donate to the channel, and we would absolutely love you for it. You know, we don't really have a Patreon thing going on here, but we would absolutely throw you a shout-out. Oh my god! Throw you a shout-out on the next stream, and of course, we can maybe... we're working on a process where if you guys are deciding to make a tip, then we're going to actually give you some input on the channel, see what you want to see us play next. You want to have a multiplayer game day with us or something like that. I mean, we'll be more than open for it. But anyways, we're gonna drop off of here. Thanks for checking it out, guys, and I'll see you guys next time. Excuse the house, by the way. I mean, it looks cool, and it looks like, but it also looks like a bomb went off. A bomb did not, in fact, go off, but we still have a lot of work to do.